Welcome back to our special review of the Glios system and their amazing assortment of action figures. I also got some toys from Toyfinity, and these were really cool. It is a two-pack of figures. First, there's this little fellow. He is called a Darkness Soldier. He's got a little black cape. Whoop. So you can see he comes with all sorts of parts. The Darkness Soldier. And along with him is this. It's called a Berserkoid. It's basically just a robot made out of a bunch of spare parts and weird stuff that you can put together. Sort of looks like Maximilian from the Black Hole. All of these parts come out and can be used for other things. It also came with probably around 50 parts. I'm not even sure how many, but look at, there's several extra heads. There's another one. A couple heads that are very cool because the heads are interchangeable. They have a face on both sides. This sort of weird alien brain face. So multiple heads. Here's another one that is reversible and has that face on the other side. Also more pointy bits. Get some knives. A couple of these sickles. And then a whole bunch of little connecting bits and accoutrements to make a jetpack or a laser gun or whatever you want. Here's some more little knives. Came with so much stuff. Here's another yellow piece, which could be a fist or a head, like it's his head there. So many parts that came in the two-pack from Toyfinity of the Darkness Soldier and the Berserkoid. If you thought that this guy looked pretty weird, I mean, look at that. He looks pretty weird, right? Big, chunky, weird death robot. Well, the next couple of figures that I have to show you are extremely weird and probably my favorite of all that I got. I don't know, because I just love all of this stuff so much. It's just so awesome. I can't wait to play with it. I mean, look at all of this collection. Ah! So amazing. So exciting. This is the most incredible toy discovery I've made in a long time. Thank you again, Craftsman, for sharing this information with me. Now, next we have a real couple of weirdos that come from a company called Biomasters. And these are the Biomass Monsters. These are so cool. Wait until you see them. Look at all of those parts there. Tentacles and claw arms and eyeball and mouth and this weird orb thing. All of these pieces come apart and are interchangeable. And to show you why I thought this toy was so excellent, I bought two of them. And I put this one together just totally different so you can see how much fun you can have just with this toy. Here he is as a totally different configuration. Same figure, all the same parts, but when I opened him up, I just put him together completely different so you can see how fun this is, what you can do with this toy, just with this, right? Now, as I was saying earlier in our program, I did perhaps go a little bit crazy with the Glios because I just saw the potential of fun that I could have with these. And I saw some of these figures that I figured I just couldn't live without. Like this one in this package here. This one comes from a company called Double G Toys. And it is a bubblegum skeleton. Now, I thought that this would just be so cool to have a skeleton and have bone pieces that you could mix in with your robots and your heroes and warriors. Now, what's interesting about this toy that I really like is that some of these swivel joints have also built-in joints inside of them. So there you can see there's his leg there, but then you can see that this pin will actually swivel there within that joint. And also a neat innovation with this guy, which is different than some of the other ones, is that the head is actually on a little ball joint there. So that's a different joint than the Glios system, but then you can take him off at the neck, and he's got a Glios peg at the bottom of it, so you can add this ball jointed skeleton head to pretty much any toy you want. Remember, all of these toys are interchangeable. Once I show them all to you, I'll use all of my powers of science and magic to create some new figures. What was also fun about getting this package from Double G Toys is that he also sent me some bonus things. He sent me 4 of these little chubby penguin figures. There's a little gray one. A little gold one, a little red one, and a little green one. And he also sent me a sticker. How awesome! I can take my sticker and put it right here on the lid of my new box designed specifically for my Glios. So peel that off right there. Double G Toys. Put that right on the front, my new Glios carrying case. So thank you, Double G Toys, for the bonus material. Of course, I love that, right? It's my favorite, getting boxes full of surprises. I could do this all day. Maybe I will, because guess what? There's still more Glios. Now, we have something very exciting. Another box of figures. These are really cool. This comes from a company called Toy Pizza. The toy line is called Knights of the Slice. There's a little QR code. Maybe it'll bring you right to their website, to Toy Pizza. Toy Pizza has something so cool. It's one of the coolest ideas I've ever heard of. Check this out. They have their very own Action Figure of the Month Club. You can find out more by visiting their Patreon. We got a few things. I selected this character here. Looks like some sort of stormtrooper from a video game called Fallout. They do have some properties from video games. What I loved about it is it looks like it has some, like, Cybermen looking type parts. So I thought that would be very fun to have. Here it shows on the back some other figures that you can get. They're all cool. They all have different colors and accessories and stuff like that. Next, I got this guy, who's very cool. Just a nice, gratifying, chunky piece of plastic that I really thought was fun to just have in your hand. He's called Malarkey Jack. He's got a really cool color scheme. Looks very 1990s. He's got a cool head here, like a little ski mask on. He comes with 4 different heads. Here's one here. Sort of a warrior of the wasteland look. The mohawk. The hockey mask. Perhaps he's a horror movie slasher. Very cool head there. Let's just put that one on. See what he looks like with that. Amazing. So cool. Wait until you see this. With that head. Very cool. And there's 2 other heads here. Comes with this head that looks sort of like a motorcycle helmet. I'm just really in love with these toys. I can't stress that enough. I mean, this is the most exciting thing that's happened to me in a long time. It's making my stay in the toy castle very fun this week. Here's the final head of Malarkey Jack. It's got this sort of trick-or-treat head. Like that old movie, Trick or Treat. And then, again, this head is reversible, so on the backside, it has sort of this skeleton face. Or perhaps it's a rotting jack-o'-lantern. Really cool. Look at that. And it also comes with a whole bunch of accessories. With this, which is a little chainsaw hand. It's ready for a night on the town to Go and slice up some cheerleaders or something in your late night B-movie horror. Came with a little shotgun. This machete. Came with a little wrench. And he came with this purple coat. So you have a little purple coat if you want to put a coat on any of your Glios in case, you know, maybe they get cold at night. Okay, now here we go. I got this from Toy Pizza. It is a two-pack. This is on a card. So they have one of their signature characters from the Knights of the Slice here, which he's called Sandhawk. And he comes with a couple different interchangeable heads. And then also, so this is a two-pack of figures. We have one signature character from Knights of the Slice. And then this toy is actually a collaboration with another toy company called Super 7. This includes a Glios version of one of their figures from their line called The Worst, which is a group of evil supervillains. Like I said, you know, these toys I'm really not interested in preserving as part of a collection so much as I am interested to play with them. They're so fun, they have so much potential, and it's such a cool concept that I can't wait to just get into playing with all of them. These guys I'm gonna open right up and get down. Here we have this guy. It's called the Sandhawk. I can already tell just by playing with him that he has lots of articulation points, so that means anywhere that there's an articulation point, he is a Glios peg that can be interchangeable with other figures. And he's got this old-time gas mask, 1940s looking soldier, but then he's sort of a translucent green skin, so maybe he's some sort of mutant World War II ghost. You can make your own stories. You can make your own toys out of these. That's what's so fun about it. These guys came with two different heads. Both of them are also translucent green, like ghost heads. Beardos. There. Comes the little gun here. Then this guy, who's really awesome. He's called, on the card here, he's called Skull Grimson. Well, upon further examination of this action figure here, I'm not sure if they're actually compatible. I'll have to do some further investigation before I just start cutting this guy apart, but still a cool figure to have. But that is a bunch of really fun stuff that I got from Toy Pizza, and look! Look here! They also sent me another sticker. Got some of their signature warlord barbarian type cyberpunk future men. I think they have comic books at the Toy Pizza and you can find out all about these guys. And I'm gonna take that sticker as well and just put it right on my box, on my collector's box here for all of my toys. There we go. Just gonna peel that off. Stick it right on the front of my box. Look at that. And now, we've reached the grand finale of toys that I've collected in the Glios line. I've saved the best for last. Something very special that I want to share with you. This toy comes from a company called Man or Monster Studios. Here it is, as part of their Warlords of War figure line. There he is. If you don't know who this is, it's got a little file card on the back. Let me explain why this toy is so special. This is a toy meant to represent William the Refrigerator Perry. If you don't know who that is, I'll tell you. Number one, he was part of the world champion Chicago Bears in 1986, who won Super Bowl 20 with the greatest team of sports entertainers of old time.
You're looking at the frizz, I'm the rookie. I may be large, but I'm no dumb cookie. You see me hit, you see me run. When I kick and pass, we'll have more fun. I can dance, you will see. The others, they all learn from me. I didn't come here looking for trouble. I just came to do the Super Bowl show.
He also recorded 3 rap albums. And there's more. He wrestled in the WWF WrestleMania 2 at the Rosemont Horizon, Chicago, Illinois. And what's awesome about that is I was there as a child and I saw him do it. And after all of this, after winning the Super Bowl, after wrestling in WrestleMania 2, after guest starring on the A-Team, he became a G.I. Joe. And not just any G.I. Joe. He was a special mail-away figure, just like Boba Fett was for Star Wars.
He's getting mad. He's getting mean. He's breaking the line. Team.
That's right, it's William the Refrigerator Perry.
The fridge is joined G.I. Joe.
Hey, you can get a free fridge. Here's how.
Collect 5 fridge certificates or call the number on the certificate and the fridge will tell you how to get in on the action with only 4 certificates. There's a $1 handling charge. See details on specially marked G.I. Joe packages.
Watch out, Cobra. Fridge is coming through.
Go, Joe!
You had to collect proof of purchase, and then mail it in, and then wait for him to show up in your mailbox. It was the coolest thing ever. It was so exciting to get one of these when you were a kid. But all of that pales in comparison about why he's so special to me. You see, when I was a child, my brother and I would play a game. We would go to each corners of our room and we'd take all our toys and a little screwdriver and we'd take them apart and we'd try to make new toys out of them to surprise or shock or make each other laugh. And one of my favorites of all time was this toy that I made out of the fridge. There you can see him. Now, why is this significant? Because, friends, this is the earliest example of a toy that I made from childhood. This is the actual toy. I still have it. It still exists. It's a Frankenstein monster of several different toys put together, mashed up to create something new. Just like the GLaDOS system. And they have a refrigerator William Perry action figure. Everything has come full circle. Oh, and what's this inside? It's a Warlords of War sticker. So he came with some bonus stuff. That's fun. We're gonna stick that right on our little box. Get all the fun stickers that are put on our box here. One thing that I just remembered, we have a local toy show that's a designer toy show here in Asheville, North Carolina. And I put a sticker here on the back of my box. It's called Assembly Required. See the sticker there? I put that on my toy box. And then, oh look, There's some stickers that you can find in our shop, but at our festival, Assembly Required, which is a festival that I've been a part of and I'm going to be a part of again, it's an annual designer toy festival. I'm going to be entertaining and providing new toys debuting at that festival, so keep a lookout, that's coming soon. But at the very first Assembly Required, I remember I had bought a GLaDOS figure from Warlords of War, Man or Monster Studios, which is their signature character here called Bognar. So I already had one, and I didn't at the time think about this GLaDOS system, and I didn't even know that it existed. I just bought the figure because I liked it, and if you're paying attention to my show, it's in that Muscle Man color that I like, the old Muscle Man, so I just thought he was a cool sort of unique independent figure that could play with the Muscle Men as a little sort of weird swamp giant. You can see here it's very, very articulated. So here we have a fridge figure. We got a claw hand. There. Might be a reference to Clobber, which is another independent toy superhero. And he's got this other big mechanical fist. Really awesome. Really excited to have this. This is so exciting to me. It really brought this whole GLaDOS thing over the edge. There's my fridge figure, and then here's some of his accessories that he came with. He comes with some accessories. He's got a gun, a knife, and a tomfa. He also came with a couple of extra bonus pegs. So we have lots of those now in our collection. GLaDOS connector pegs. Got a little piece of body armor there. Came with an extra set of little hands here. These are more just regular fists, but those are good for holding his accessories. And then he came with three other heads. Here he is with some cool sunglasses on with his helmet. And he came with this head that looks sort of like a cobra bats. He came straight up with a cobra head. So maybe he's a double agent, I don't know. But that's cool, now I have a little cobra head so we can use that. Now it's time for me to let my imagination go loose and start playing with some GLaDOS. You too can start your own GLaDOS collection. Find the link below. It'll connect you with all the available toys that you can find in their system, and you can start a collection of your very own and start having as much fun as I am. Thank you for watching. What a fun show we had today! I can't wait to play more with my toys and build new monsters and creations and hopefully share them with you! Check out the link below where you can find all of the Glios that are available now. They update it regularly, and you can start a collection of your very own. And don't forget to shop or donate to me, Toy Box, America's favorite cartoon witch. See some of my new ragamuffins. There are over 100 to choose from, along with t-shirts, stickers, magnets, and other handmade toys in my shop now. Or, if you like, you can just donate directly to me.